This is The Morning Shower,
brought to you by Late Night Hump.
Let the news wash over you.
With Jordan Freed,
Brendan O'Brien,
and Reena Ezra.
These are your ShowerHead Lines.
An 84-year-old driver accidentally reversed his car on top of another vehicle outside the John F. Kennedy Medical Center on Monday morning. Authorities received a call around 10:45 a.m. about a two-car accident in which a Toyota was on top of an unoccupied parked Acura vehicle. The driver was not injured and no summons were issued. The feat was so skilled that New Jersey thought about adding parking your cars on cars to the state driving test.
Nearly 200 tortoises, all younger than 3 months old, were found inside a suitcase at a Galapagos Islands airport on Sunday morning in what officials say was an attempt to smuggle the animals off the islands. The tortoises were discovered by staff at Seymour Airport on the island of Baltra and have been taken into custody. Oh, sure, when Ted Cruz and his family want to flee to Cancun for vacation, he gets off scot-free. But when this family of 200 wants to do the same, they get taken in? Talk about your double standards.
A man was fatally shot in a crowded Philadelphia mall food court Monday evening. The 21-year-old victim was shot multiple times in the chest and pronounced dead on the scene. That's what happens when you cut the food court line full of hangry people.
Baylor women's basketball head coach Kim Mulkey says Final Four shouldn't test for COVID-19. Wouldn't it be a shame to keep COVID testing? And then you got kids that end up testing positive or something, and then they don't get to play in the Final Four? It would be a shame. And if there's one thing I know about college athletes, it's that they know how to cheat on tests.
An Indiana woman allegedly enlisted her daughter and her daughter's boyfriend to help her murder her ex with fentanyl-laced oatmeal and strangle him with his favorite tie following a custody dispute. An autopsy later found that the man had been strangled to death, had suffered blunt force trauma to his head, and had traces of fentanyl in his system. Wait, so they didn't even need the fentanyl to kill him? Damn, what a waste of perfectly good oatmeal.
A mafia fugitive has been arrested in the Dominican Republic after inadvertently tipping off police with his culinary hobby. After 7 years on the run, Mark Farron Claude Biart was tracked down through a YouTube cooking channel he started with his wife. The alleged gangster's love for Italian cuisine and tattoo ink made his arrest possible. Though he carefully hid his face, Biart failed to disguise his distinctive body tattoos. Police said they believe Biart is a member of the notorious 'Ndrangheta crime syndicate, one of the most feared and powerful in Europe. Hey, Stanley Tucci, if you're still searching for Italy, I found it.
Volkswagen plans to change its brand name in the United States to Volkswagen as it shifts its production increasingly towards electric vehicles and tries to distance itself from an emissions cheating scandal. If they really wanted to distance themselves, they should choose a name not abbreviated VW. Maybe even stop making cars. Now that they're called Volkswagen, they can make electric boats, or TVs, or vibrators. Anything electric, really.
A modder has made it possible to mine Bitcoin on a Game Boy, albeit very, very slowly. Stack Smashing, the modders who made this mining modification possible, have said that on a Game Boy, it would only take a few quadrillion years to mine a unit of Bitcoin. This must be how you acquire this generational wealth that people are always talking about. I better get started mining now. To my great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandchildren, if you're listening out there, this is proof that your great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandpappy loves you. Enjoy your Bitcoin and don't spend it all in one place.
Sherry Ville, a married New Yorker, said that Governor Andrew Cuomo grabbed her by her face, gave her unwanted kisses, and appeared to come onto her in front of her son while touring flood damage on her property in 2017. Cuomo leaned over and kissed her cheeks in a highly sexual manner. I guess Cuomo's visit wasn't only to assess the flood damage, but to also drown in her pussy.
Ghislaine Maxwell, the longtime associate of Jeffrey Epstein, was charged on Monday for the first time with sex trafficking of a minor, as federal prosecutors accused her of grooming a 14-year-old girl to engage in sexual acts with Mr. Epstein and later paying for it. Somewhere in hell, I'm sure Jeffrey Epstein is happy Ghislaine is finally getting recognized for her work. Good for her.
Former President Trump and former First Lady Melania Trump have launched their official website, vowing to remain a tireless champion for Americans. The site, 45office.com, will allow individuals to submit correspondence, schedule requests, and press inquiries. This is not to be confused with the similar website, 45 Orifice, which is a website where you can pay to have smoke blown up your asshole while spouting your toxic opinions.
Thank you for showering with us.
Lather, rinse, repeat every day before noon.
Scrub-a-dub-dub at latenighthump.com.